I guess we're live.
Are we?
Let's see.
Someone should give us some evidence that we're online. You guys over there, give us some proof that we know that this stuff is working. Oh, hello.
Can you hear us?
Can you hear us properly? Yep. Obviously you can see us, but can you hear us? Yeah, and we know that we look absolutely beautiful over here. But can you hear our beautiful voices as well?
This works, they say. Hello, everybody.
Yeah. They say a lot of things.
Oh, they can hear us.
Who said that? Yes, I can hear you. Okay, that's a good point.
I like pie.
Who likes pie? Yeah, I like pie as well. Pie is good. Keeps your stomach big.
There's quite a lot of messages coming in.
Yeah, I have to say, guys, this is absolutely great. It's nice to see that there's so many people writing to us.
Yeah.
And I mean that we're sharing this moment together, but there's so many messages coming. It's like trying to watch all of these and try to say something. Oh, sing the way of the fire, please. We already sang that a bit live, and now we're going to have a tiny break with that, so we'll come back to you, scream at my face, soon. Yeah, this is water. Yeah, hail Yaris. Yaris doing a bunch of other stuff at the moment, so it's like the two of us are now replacing this one blondie.
Yeah, he's too busy with other stuff.
Yeah.
Recovering from the weekend and yeah, a lot of other stuff.
Yeah, we had a super nice weekend. The first shows related to the new album, and they were absolutely superb. We played in two cities in Finland, and they were sold out. And I have to say, we got a lot of good feedback on that.
Yes.
So we're super duper happy to go on the road in Europe starting on next Friday.
Yeah, 19th.
Yeah, and then of course in December.
U.S. Canadian tour.
Yeah, gonna have the first U.S. well, North American tour. So definitely looking forward for that. Personally, I really don't know what to expect.
Yeah.
Except I only have personal experience from Canada side with Northern a few years back, and that was superb, so to say.
Mm. Yeah, I've never been there, so really looking forward to.
Yeah, but we're gonna have a bunch of shows there.
Yeah,
starting from Phoenix, and then going all the way north, the west coast, and through the north to the whole territory, and ending up in the east coast. How many shows were there?
About 20, I think.
Mm. Sounds super good. Well, it's absolutely great. And let's check this stuff out.
Somebody's saying, is that guitar behind us?
Where? Oh.
Yeah, you can see, you can see one of them. I don't know if I can turn this iMac. I can try. There's a couple more. Kind of hard to see. There's 7 guitars on the wall at the moment. This is my working room at Sonic Bump Studios in Helsinki. I teach here and and do my practicing, some recording stuff.
Yeah. Being sweating here,
mm-hmm.
rehearsing, singing stuff, and playing stuff, and yeah, now we are ready to go on the road, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Been practicing a lot for the new songs and for the old song as well, and whoa. I'm being like an ADHD over here because there's like so many comments going on. Okay, there's one. When did you start playing your instruments, Jukka and Teemu? Well, I'm gonna say briefly. I was picked up being the bass player in ground school in the third grade. This little guy back then started to play the, what is it called, the upright bass.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I was back then like maybe 1 meter tall, and the upright bass was 2 meters, so I had a lot of challenges back then, but, and still I do, but it's going a lot better than then, but I've been playing since then, more or less, but for several years.
I didn't know that you started with the double bass. You should bring it to the Wintersun shows.
Yeah, try to shred my ass off with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rockabilly stuff in between.
What about you?
I started, I think, year 2000, 12 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Dad had bought acoustic guitar for the family as a Christmas present, and
yeah,
I picked it up and then started learning stuff with some friends.
Mm-hmm. So it's sort of... Mm-hmm. South American tour, well, I hope it's gonna happen next year. Next year we're gonna have shows coming, nothing confirmed yet, but includes a lot of territories, territories that we haven't visited before, like, there are a lot of territories that we haven't, but South America, probably even Africa somewhere there, and Asia, and yeah, and probably
Australia.
Yeah, Australia, and maybe, and probably another US tour, and probably another European tour as well. Greece, next year, Ireland tour would be great. I was there for a week, our holidays this year's. Loved the country, didn't visit the very north though, but absolutely great. Would love to play in every pub in Ireland.
Yeah.
SR basses rule. Got the, oh, you have the Ibanez SR 705. Yeah, that's a nice bass. I play with the SR 5005. That's I think it's a very, very nice bass guitar that Ibanez has made. And we're getting a bunch of messages over here, like text messages as well.
Move to the right, move to the left.
Some people are saying move to the left, move to the left. Right, I like to have half of my face online. Thank you. Will we go on tour with Enzifer?
That would be fun.
Yeah, that would be fun. It would be like East meets West. So it's like Enzifer and Wintersun, right? more stuff coming. Yeah, Inferno Festival in Oslo would be nice to do as well. Haven't been playing. We haven't been playing. We were in Sweden.
No, we never played Sweden.
I'm sorry.
Or Norway.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I confused myself with the northern shows, probably. But yeah, Inferno in Norway would be cool, and also in Sweden and Denmark as well. We haven't been visiting the neighbor countries either, in Russia as well.
Mm. You could go on tour with Wintersun and Norther.
Yeah, it would be great. Unfortunately, no, there is no more. Yeah. There was like everybody in our friends, and everybody had a good old times. well, good old times and good new times, but unfortunately we didn't have enough time to keep the band active anymore, so would have been nice to do double shifts on the same tour, but that's not possible, unfortunately.
Any chances for signing session during Heidenfest?
Definitely. We're gonna... At least like official, unofficial stuff after the shows.
We try to hang out at the merch stands whenever we can after the shows.
I'm sure we try to do that every day if possible. At least most of the days we will definitely do that.
Yeah.
Mm.
And for US there's even some in-store signings.
Yeah.
Can't remember which ones they were.
Do you remember which
there's cities? Gonna be news when they confirm.
Yeah. Yeah, just check our website. There's gonna be more info on that closer at the latest close to the US tour, so check that out. Mm-hmm. Blondes or brunettes? Does he mean a coffee blend or something? Who knows? Boris Barrera 1, you have to be more precise with the question. We don't know what you mean with blondes or brunettes. Teemu, do you like Ingvi?
Yeah, sure.
More is more.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. Ingvi is a huge influence for me, especially in the early days. He was more, but yeah, I still like his stuff.
Yeah,
maybe not the biggest influence anymore, but still cool stuff. Great player.
Hmm. Teemu, how different is Imperanon to Wintersun technical? In Wintersun technical techniques.
Technical techniques.
Same for you, go with Norder. You go first.
Well, it's quite different music. Imperanon had some challenging stuff as well, but I think Wintersun is maybe a little more tricky even, and also since we're doing nowadays more vocals as well, live backing vocals, that make some stuff super tricky to try to sing and play something totally different melodies at the same time.
Yeah.
But it's fun.
Yeah, that's a lot of fun indeed, and we have like jumped to the next level with that stuff.
Mm.
But yeah, when it comes to Norther and Wintersun, it's like Wintersun is very technical stuff, and well, Norther had some technical riffs as well, but briefly, if I can say that, Norther is more or less like playing punk compared to Wintersun. Wintersun has a lot more technical riffs and, so to speak, a lot more notes in general than Norther ever had. Megadeth or Metallica? I have to say that when it comes to these two ancient legends, yesterday saw the Sonisphere 2011 documentary, and I have to say that I vote for Metallica. I like both bands. Megadeth has really good songs, but there was this one singer in this Megadeth kind of band who was a bit tired, I guess.
Really?
Yeah, very tired. Okay. But they have kick-ass songs and legends, of course.
Yeah. Yeah, I like them both too, I guess. Maybe Megadeth is even more my cup of tea.
Mm. Do you guys like deathcore, such as Born of Osiris, Veil of Maya, Periphery? Well, personally I haven't listened to that stuff, but when it comes to deathcore, or is it mathcore, or is it grind, or whatever it's called, it's like when it comes to bands like Nasum or Dillinger Escape Plan, I like stuff like that. But have you heard these bands?
Well, I know the names and I've listened to Periphery. I actually saw them, they were supporting Dream Theater here in Helsinki.
Oh, okay.
They've got cool stuff.
And, yeah.
Misha is monster player as well.
Yeah.
There's somebody asking about guitar influences. Well, Yngwie was there already. I've got a lot of fusion kind of stuff that I've been into for a while. Like Sean Lane has been a huge influence on me musically and also technically and the whole personality. And Godfrey Govan, definitely one of my favorites. John Petrucci, then the usual Steve Vai, Joe Satriani, these guys. There's a lot of influences, not only guitar playing. I think it's also really fresh to try to get influence to your guitar playing from other stuff than guitar playing. If you try to repeat what others have done, then you just come up with stuff that has been made already. So if you like try to make sounds on the guitar that you've heard in somebody playing with a violin or whatever different instrument, that's interesting and inspiring too. Jason Becker too, also one of the greatest.
Oh yeah, over there. Wait, I saw something over here. How did you guys end up playing in Wintersun? Whoa, that's a longer story.
But I
can say it briefly as well. But at least when it comes to me, I've known Jari for many, many years. All the way back when Norther started and when Ensiferum started. And I've been friends with Jari ever since. And I remember him playing first Wintersun demos at our rehearsal place in this in Helsinki, a place called Nosturi. And we were back then even wondering, we were partying there and Jari was showing some demos and we were like, who the hell is gonna play drums for this stuff? This is so insane. That who's gonna do this properly? And back then Jari didn't even know like what to do, but back then it was just like Jari was saying that he's doing this on the side of Ensiferum just for himself, but as we know, we sit here, it grew to be something a bit totally different. But I joined Wintersun. We both joined Wintersun in 2004. Yeah, it just came asking me after one Norther show that would I like to join, and I said, yeah, of course. But in the first week or two, he didn't believe me that I will join. He thought that I'm just saying, tricking him or something, that he said that I'm not serious at all, that I don't want to join, although I'm saying that. And I said, God damn, I'm very serious with this. Yeah. And with you then, we was more like more serious auditioning.
Yeah, making it short. I contacted Jari myself when I heard the self-titled album, and wrote him a mail that I really liked the music, and if you're ever putting up a band, I would like to audition or whatever. Then we mailed back and forth, and then he put the ad that he was searching for guitar player and keyboard player, and then I went for the audition, and went okay. And then after some weeks, Jari called that there's two guys that he can't decide between, and that he would give this CD with live guitar tracks that would need to be rehearsed for the gigs. And then we had like, I don't know, 2-3 weeks time to practice, and then there was the second audition. And, I guess I've never practiced that intensely. Like, I'm still trying to go to school at the same time, but that was like 10 hours, 12 hours a day practicing the stuff, and yeah, went well. And then after the second audition, it was a while, didn't hear anything, and then like, I think just a day before Christmas Eve 2004, Gary called me and asked, do you still want to join the band?
Yeah.
And I, of course, said that, definitely.
Yeah.
I think he said that, are you sure you want to join that? I guess he said you might regret it or something. But I never regret it. I mean, Gary said that to me.
Because I remember similar kind of stuff, not that I would regret, but stuff like that. You're not serious.
Yeah,
you're seriously joining. It's like, what the hell? Yes, I am. And so are you. But I have to say that we have a super duper team. So
yeah.
Jari made the right people to join the band. And then, yeah, of course, he had earned experience asking Kai to play the drums. But on the first album, Kai was just a session guy. But
session Kai.
But,
session Kai.
Yeah. But then became a permanent Kai. Jukka, are you gonna make new material for Cain's Offering after Winters on the Stradivarius has toured? Nope. Cain's Offering, it was like a one-time project, basically. And Mr. Kotipelto and Mr. Liimatainen has their acoustic performances and stuff like that, so I don't see anything happening with Cain's Offering.
Somebody asks, how long do you guys practice to play the new songs live? Well, everybody practices by themselves, and then we try to rehearse whenever we can, but because Kai is busy with Swallow the Sun as well, and he lives 400 kilometers apart from the rest of us, it's always hard to organize the rehearsals, but usually we have 2-3 rehearsals before a gig.
So, yeah.
And yeah, then everybody, of course, rehearses themselves as much as they can.
One thing that just popped in my head when it comes to how long did you guys have to practice? Well, of course, everybody practices individually, and in general, someone might learn to play it properly in a few days, and for some person it might take for weeks, at least in general. Well, not in our case. Of course, we used a lot of time for it as well, because like we said earlier, that we're doing a lot of vocals and playing, so it's very, very challenging for us as well. But of course, in a good way, that we like challenges.
Yeah, definitely.
Mm.
And also, when we go on tour, that's gonna be kind of practice that you can't do at home, practicing by yourself or at rehearsal place, getting that kind of routine.
Yeah.
And yeah, I guess we're gonna, just gonna develop all the time and gonna get better when there's more shows coming.
Yeah. Will you perform at Wacken? We'll see then. Yeah. We will play there definitely if they pick.
Yeah.
Choose us to play there. Can you name all the bands you have played in?
Well,
I can.
Well, I can too. I haven't played in so many.
Go first.
Well, actually, the only ones that we have named are Imperanen and Wintersun. Well, there's been some projects, like somebody mentioned Speed Piano Solo before, and played in a Metallica cover band, and Rent musical band, and of course some school projects back in the day, and blues band and stuff. But no names really.
Oh yeah, I've never probably told you, but my first band I ever played, it was called, what was it called? Vamgral or something like that.
Oh, I actually remember my first real band as well. It was called Super Vispila.
What is it? Super Vispila? What is it? What's the thing? What is a Vispila in English?
I don't know. The one that you whipped cream with.
Yeah, Super Mixer or something.
Yeah, that was back in the...
Yeah.
Back in the days. I hadn't played maybe a year.
Yeah, when it comes to me after that, actually basically not that much. Yeah, I used to play in a band called Medieval Art. Interesting name. And, after that actually it was Norther. And also pre-state of Norther, when Norther still wasn't Norther. I actually played with Tony and Petri back in the days before Norther was formed. I left because I thought that they were making shitty songs. I didn't like the music back then. But then I joined a year or 2 years after. And then it was a totally different story then.
And also Amberian Dawn.
Oh yeah, Amberian Dawn. I'm getting demented here. Yeah, Amberian Dawn, and I'm still playing Amberian Dawn.
What size are your ear piercings?
Oh yeah, these. 8 millimeters, I think so. I think so because I don't even remember that I have these ear piercings anymore. I have them maybe like over 10 years.
Somebody asks if there's any satanic background in the music we play. No, there's no satanic or any other religion related background in our music. We try to stay out of the religion and politics and that kind of stuff.
Well, when it comes to mental and spirituality.
Yeah, that's different.
There is that stuff, yes, but when it comes to some
organized religion, I guess we're all kind of against that in way or another.
Yeah. Jukka, describe shitty songs. Shitty songs. Well, that's actually a hard question, because one person might say the shitty songs are the ones that the band can't play properly. But then if there are good songs, the songs are good, even the band would play in a crappy way. It's probably the hardest question I've ever got. What do you think, Tim? What is a shitty song?
I guess that would be something that was put together with no feeling or maybe that can even be a good song with that feeling. I don't know. Anything can be shitty or a good song. It's just a matter of opinion. I don't know. I guess it's easier to say what we like to hear in a song. I like to hear catchy melodies and also complex stuff. And I definitely technical stuff when I hear great playing on a song, and it kind of catches my ear. Somebody asked what it says on my shirt. Bare knuckle pickups. Where's my thumb? Do you like Andy James? Do you know Andy James? I know Andy James.
Who is Andy James?
English guitarist, teacher. Okay. Super fast picking. Really great technique. Listen to some of his solo stuff. Not maybe my cup of tea, but yeah, great player.
Someone says over here that he or she's not leaving until he or she sees some goddamn air guitar. Or there's some
air bass.
Air bass. Good night.
That's my air guitar.
Yeah. Yeah, air guitar like Bill and Ted, exactly.
Facebook questions, we have here some Facebook questions, but there's so many questions coming all the time.
Tell us, is the Silver Leaves best song Jari made?
We haven't heard the ready
version. It's not a ready version yet, but let's say that it's a very, very awesome song.
Yeah.
And definitely, although we split the albums in time one and time two, they're totally equal to each other, and those two albums make a whole what is it? Well, a whole
they complete concept each other. Yeah.
Yeah, and when it comes to Silver Leaves, it's a song that really, really touches your emotions, at least when it comes to me when I heard that. Probably one of the most beautiful songs Jari has ever written.
There's been a few questions about if I give Skype lessons. Yeah, I've considered about it, and I think I have to do some preparations to get set up working, but I'm trying to start giving Skype lessons in January after the US tour. And also I'd like to start giving lessons on tour if somebody wants to come to have lessons at the venues, but we have to see how it goes with the promo stuff and how our daily schedules are going to be.
Yeah.
If we have the time, so after these two tours we're going to know more about that. And there was questions about what languages we speak.
Can you speak French? Je m'appelle Magnifique Jukka. Where was it? Which languages can we speak? Well, mine is related basically to Finnish, Swedish and English.
Yeah.
And tiny bit of German as well.
Yeah, same for me. I think probably we both know German even better than Swedish. At least I do.
I'm like 50-60 on that.
Yeah.
Jukka, you will do a bass solo in any song.
Kind of,
yeah, but I would say it's still more like melody stuff. Well, it's kind of solo stuff, but it's not like a spotlight thing, so to say. Or maybe on live I will, one day.
You'll get a spotlight.
Yeah, I'll get a spotlight and go into a panic. Horna says that he or she has a Winterson tattoo. Really? Whoa.
Was it the one that we saw on Facebook, like the whole arm?
Oh yeah, the Winterson logo. Yeah. Hmm.
There was a question about the Winterson guitar bass tap book. We've been talking about that, and well, the thing is, Jari never writes any taps of his stuff. He only makes the songs and then he records them. So when I write taps, I just use my ear to transcribe stuff. And yeah, that's usually how I learn the Winterson songs, and then if there's some really tricky, then I ask Jari, just like this. But I've got some stuff already written down from the self-titled album as well as for the new songs. And yeah, if we find a good way to release that book in the future, we could do that.
Yeah, that would be very nice to do. we'll see what happens with that.
But yeah, that would be something that I would really like to do.
Yeah. Jukka vocals on time one. Yeah, I have some low growling in a few songs.
And Sons of Winter and Stars.
Sons of Winter and Stars, and on time as well. The guy who is a very, very low growling dude, it's me.
Should we check some of the
We were supposed to
stuff.
Yeah, some people sent us questions over our Facebook site, so
I think we answered already some of these. Will Winterson ever add the live keyboard player to the band? We get asked this quite often.
Yeah. And you remember that was many years ago that we were looking for a keyboard player. But one never showed up.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah, and then now it would be kind of impossible. The stuff is not so tricky to play necessarily, but there's so many layers that it's impossible to do live with one or two keyboard players, because there's hundreds of backing tracks, so then it would be kind of would it make sense to have a keyboard player or three keyboard players plus the backing tracks.
Yeah, we would have to have several keyboard players.
Yeah, definitely.
And still at the backup track, so on the other hand, it doesn't make any sense.
Somebody asks, how long did my hair grow? It's around here now. In about 2 years, I guess. No, a little bit more. 2010, I went to the army.
They grow fast. Well, actually, no, that's a week. Could you say Viva Mexico Carbone or Cabrone? I don't know how should I say it properly, but something like that. Russia? Yes, we will come to Russia next year, I hope. Uh-huh. Been there myself a few times and had very, very nice experiences. Very, very nice shows. Is there something else over there?
Let's see. About XFX units, Fractal Audio. Do you use any of them for recording? Or simply as effects units? We actually didn't use that much XFX on the Time album. We used real amps in there, Mesa Boogie, Tri-Axis, Simulglass, and also some line-in stuff like Vox, Tone Lab, and Hughes and Gettner, Tubeck, I think. But we're using XFX Live because it's so compact size to fly with, and the sound is good. It's easy to work with MIDI, and works well for us live.
Yeah. Alpha Loopy says that Moomins are creepy. I don't think so.
Moomins, think some of them are the...
Well, yeah, they might be... they might be creepy characters in a way, but... I have to say, when it comes to Moomins, it's very, very nice... can I call it series or... Well, books, all the stuff, because it's... It's kind of like children's stories, but actually they're written in an adult way as well, so actually adults can get a lot from that when it comes to all kinds of philosophic stuff and there's a lot of hidden text, so to say, at least in the books. Any plans on releasing Time 1 and 2 together in a single set? Maybe a Super HD Blu-ray or DVD kind of thing? Yes.
Uh, There's been some.
Yeah, we've been talking about it.
Making something really special after the both albums have come out, and
yeah,
we've toured after both albums.
Yeah.
But
there are a few concepts up in the air, and
maybe not. We shouldn't reveal too much yet.
No, but I just said a few concepts.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of stuff to be planned.
Yeah. But
sorry, being diplomatic here, but we'll see what happens.
Yeah. But many people ask, why did we split time one and two?
Mm.
Well, besides the fact that it was too heavy to mix both at once, because only the half of the song took 4 months or even more to mix.
Yeah.
So to make the band active and actually get on the road and kind of get more time to finish the second part, that was a mutual agreement with the record label and us to split it up. And I think also, like with live shows, it's better that now we can build it up step by step.
Yeah, more. exactly.
And you know, then if we do the special set with time one and two, then we're already in having better equipment and better live production as well.
Yeah. Yeah, so, exactly.
But Jyväskylä and Helsinki.
Hmm?
How was the atmosphere? I think it was totally amazing.
Fantastic, yeah.
Yeah. We played some shows 2011, but haven't played so much lately, so it was definitely a really heartwarming welcome.
Yeah, from definitely.
The fans.
It was so great to share these shows with the guys and share shows to come a lot when it comes to touring for Time One. And at least when it comes to me, I have to say one thing, that I was very touched for the shows, because I personally, and all of us of course, we want to perform for people and share the moment, like the music that we, where we come from with the music, and to everybody to hear, and especially now on the Finnish show, I saw so many people having fun and actually being crying as well.
And singing along to the songs.
Singing along to the songs, and that's something that I really feel so touched, that I feel that I've done something that has meaning. Not just going, playing on stage and being there like some rock stars. Definitely not. Yeah. It's so great to share the good music moments at the shows.
Yeah, feels great to see that we can deliver the feeling and people are really touched and emotional at the shows. Somebody asks, what pickups am I using?
Nice.
This is the pickups. Bertnago, I've got Black Hawk pickups in my Blue Ibanez and Aftermath pickups in my J Customs. I've got two J Customs now that we take on tour. Both have Aftermaths.
Is it okay for you that Jari writes most of the stuff alone? Well, of course there are several ways how bands work, but of course Wintersun started as Jari's solo project. And Jari's solo thing, so I fully understand it, that it's like when it comes to that, he's doing this stuff. But of course nowadays I have to say that there's four guys in the band and we are as a unit, and I think we how should I explain it, we influence one another and support one another and work as a team when it comes to everything related to the music around it to make everything work for Wintersun.
Yeah, definitely.
Mm. There are just insane questions coming, guys.
Funny stuff.
This is supposed to be a normal chat, at least a noon chat for the Americans. So that's a bit too rough stuff to say at the daytime, at least for those guys.
How many guitars do I own? I think I have 20 Ibanez guitars at the moment.
I'm fine with 3 bass guitars at the moment.
Somebody asked if I'm selling any. Not at the moment, but maybe I've got some guitars that don't get used so much, so maybe at some point.
Metallin is asking, will Jari or Kai come to talk to us? We're gonna be here today, but Jari and Kai will be on the shows and of course other interviews as well, so we're trying to share these things equally, that no one has personally a too big too big amount of interviews and chats and stuff. Haha, only 3 bases. Hey, I only have 2 hands, man. 2 hands. What if I have 3 bases? That's almost too much. Best movie is maybe Pan's Labyrinth. Yeah, 20 guitars, sick bro.
A lot of people ask what do you do with 20 guitars, but I use 4 or 5 different tunings. Well, in Winter Sun we use 3 different tunings at the moment, and then when I teach there's a couple extra tunings needed, so that's already some guitars. And then of course every guitar has distinctive sound and distinctive feel, and they look different and they're nice to just look at and to collect as well. I like to put my whatever I can save to guitars rather than some other crap.
Are all the band members in Winter Sun Finnish? Yes, except Kai. Kai is from Vaasa. Yeah, he's a Finnish guy as well. A bit more from the north than the rest of us. But, where was it?
Somebody keeps asking, what if I pay you a beer and you sign me a drawing in Munich? I can sign a drawing, no problem, but...
you can give me the beer and Teemu can sign.
Yeah. I don't actually drink beer. I don't
mind the taste. Me neither, No beers needed. Someone was asking how was it at the military or something? How was it?
The first 2 months was the basic training. It was quite hard time, you know, the superiors screaming and making you do stuff that seems stupid at times. But I kind of also enjoyed that there's a lot of sports that we did, and a lot of fun stuff too. Gun range
A lot of fun stuff like gun range and it was cool. I have to say I was in the military as well, like Jari. Like Kai.
Yeah, everybody went to army.
Yeah.
For me, after 2 months, I applied for the military band, for the show band, and got in, and then spent the rest of the 7 months just playing guitar and doing gigs. So that was kind of easy. a lot of fun.
Hey, okay, if you answer my question about Croatia, I'll buy you anything you want.
Fourth base.
Yeah, I want to have a fourth base. Yeah, we'll try to come to Croatia next year.
Somebody asks if there's... Finnish vocals on time 2. There might be.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can sign in.
Or can, how can I? What was it?
Let's see. Trying to sign in to this chat so you can write some. See what else we have.
Yeah. Okay, where is it?
Jukka and Teemu, how much does Jari push you guys in the studio while recording? He seems to be a bit of a perfectionist. Sometimes, well, he seems.
Yeah, sometimes, but I guess there's a bit of that falls in all of us, one way or the other. Because I remember a time when I was recording Jari's guitars and he kicked me out from the studio room because I was being like a too strict judge for him for a while.
Really?
Yeah.
I remember that.
But I don't know. Well, Jari doesn't push us at least in the wrong way.
No,
I mean, he doesn't push us at all.
I think he knows very well what he wants. But he also knows what we can deliver.
Yeah.
And we know what Jari wants to hear. And so it's kind of easy to work together.
Yeah. Yes, definitely.
And Jari is not like... Yeah, I think he would make a good producer because he's kind of calm and not...
Yeah, Jari is very...
...starting to yell at you if you don't get it recorded at once.
No, definitely not. Jari is a super, superb, easygoing guy. Yeah. Do you shave your armpits? Yes, I do, actually, because they stink if I don't.
Me too.
How tall are you, Jukka? You seem very tall in the pics. Really? Just 186 centimeters. We will come to Russia, we will come to Ireland, hopefully next year. Jukka never thought of buying a six-string fretless bass. I used to have a six-stringer, but not a fretless. It will be a great influence on the future album. Actually, we were talking about it with Jari. And we'll see what happens. I'm not that familiar when it comes to fretlesses, but they have a nice sound. But I think you really have to test and try if they work properly on the songs. No, our feet doesn't stink.
Question on Facebook about clinic videos. Yeah, that was there was this one clinic that we did with the Kai here in Finland, and played some Winterson stuff and also some stuff from this project called Speed Piano Solo. It's basically a project from insane keyboard player Risto Kupiainen, a good friend of mine, absolute monster keyboard player. And I met him many years ago, and we did some funny shredding keyboard guitar stuff, songs. So I performed one of them at the clinic as well. Now lately we haven't done that much stuff together, but maybe someday we'll release something again. There's more questions about Skype lessons, costs, and how long they should be. I haven't totally figured it out yet, but there's gonna be more info about it towards the end of the year. What car do you drive, Jukka?
What car do I drive? Well, one car that I drive is my girlfriend's Austrian attack wagon. That's what it is called. It's like a fast black vacuum cleaner.
Do you guys have a studio not live recording of The Way of the Fire? Yeah, well, The Way of the Fire is recorded and it's gonna be released on Time 2.
Yeah. Someone is saying that I should smile more.
Hey, yeah, I don't.
Who would win, Jari or Chuck Norris? Well, that's a tricky one. Yeah, I would say Jari in the end, because Chuck really haven't met Jari, and I think he would be freaked out.
Favorite colors? I guess blue is my favorite color. Depends on what. I like black clothing, I like simple colors, black and white stuff. I like blue guitars, and I like any colors.
Yeah, we would like to jam in a way, but maybe we're gonna do it in another session. There's so many questions coming and going, so we don't wanna skip all the other stuff. Do you pull each other's hair? I just did a while back. Yes, we do. Opinions on black metal. I like listening to black metal. Well, of course, depends on what kind, but I like all kinds of music. I have a big black metal past, so to say, and I still really like it. Stuff like Emperor and Borknagar and stuff like that. Although Borknagar is more or less like Viking metal, but very blackish.
Do we know the guys in Sonata Arctica and Meshuggah? Not really. I mean, we've seen them around at festivals and said hi and stuff.
Yeah.
We don't know them.
Yeah, there was some stuff going on with Meshuggah, at least when it came to Kai
and Thomas.
Yeah. Meshuggah's drummer, that they should make babies together. So that would be the ultimate drummer baby born or something.
Yeah, and we were here at the Sonic Bomb Studios at the same time with Sonata Arctica beginning of this year. So I think they just came in when we were finishing the guitar, so they came to listen to the stuff. And I think they digged it.
Yeah. A reunion with Noether.
Already?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Just split like, what was it, a few months ago. Yeah, it was planned. We're gonna come back. No. Noether won't.
Do you play World of Warcraft? Nope.
Once I was thinking that I would like to try it, because I used to play a lot of fantasy games. Role games, but if I would start doing that, then I wouldn't probably do anything else anymore. So, no, I don't.
Signature Ibanez made to be made available. Would be great, but it's not really up to us. Of course, if the band grows, if the possibility comes up that we could do a signature models, I'd be totally up to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me too, definitely. But I have to say that I'm very, very pleased at the moment with the Ibanez SR5005 basses. Really, really like them. What about Diablo? The Finnish Diablo?
Or maybe it's about the game.
Oh, the game. Well, when it comes to the band, it's absolutely great.
Yeah.
Very professional stuff. When it comes to the game, I used to play Diablo 1 or 2. Probably the second one, a few years ago. Do we have something on the Facebook side? Out of Noether, Cain's Offering and Winter Sun, what is your favorite song? When it comes to Noether, I still have to say that Frozen Angel and a song called Everything are the best. I don't know which one. When it comes to Cain's Offering, that's a hard one. You don't know. Winter Sun has... We don't have a poor song at all.
Mm.
All of them are very good, but at least at the moment, my favorite is Time, the title track of the new album. What about you, Teemu? What are the best Noether songs?
I think I still remember some from the first one. Like I told you just a couple of days ago, the confession I bought your first album.
I was like,
when it came out, I still remember when I went to Stockman in Tampere, I think it was.
Yeah.
Like, sounded pretty good back then.
Yeah, back then. Are you guys fans of Tour? Yes, we are fans of the guys in person.
Yes.
Very nice guys, all of them.
And cool music too.
Yeah.
Really original ingredients.
Yeah. And Time 1 is great, guys. I love the first track as well. Well, I have to say it's cool that you like it. Unfortunately, the album is not out yet.
Mm.
Which is a very, very sad thing in a way that I understand that nowadays it's very easy to get everything from the internet because it's for free and so easy to get. But unfortunately, the album leaked on the internet because of someone or a few people. which I really don't appreciate at all, because if you put it this way, that we have spent years of making the album, the whole concept, and spending zillions of hours for that stuff, and then just some dimwit puts it on the internet and everybody gets it, like, just like that, and it's for free. It's like, not that respectful at all. But of course, a tiny bit of me is like, it's so easy to get, so hopefully as many people as possible will listen to it and like it and meet us at the shows. That's the tiny positive side of that, but in the end, that's not cool at all. I personally think, of course, being as a musician, and Tim also knows this, as that how much time and effort you put on the albums. It's not just that we just go drink beer and make some songs and that's it. We really put our hearts and soul for that and really push us on the edge. And would be cool that someone would like to support the stuff, because when it comes to buying the albums, it's something that keeps the bands alive as well. That we can keep on going, because we don't have money enough to continue making music, or at least what's required of Wintersun, since it's very gigantic project, the song projects that we use.
Somebody asked, what pick do I use? This is the one we just received. These from Dunlop. It's a Altex Sharp 1.0 millimeters. Really good one. You can buy it soon in the Wintersun webshop.
Yeah. Nice sales speech. Which is the most technical, difficult song of time?
I think
all of the songs, because not the entire songs, but a few parts, because we have to sing and play at the same time.
Yeah.
There are these small what is it?
Sections,
yeah. Or do you have
I think Sons of Winter and Stars is challenging as a whole.
Yeah.
That has a lot of singing stuff going there, and
it's all different.
Yeah,
different
parts.
Yeah.
Also guitar wise, there's a lot of tricky stuff.
Yeah, definitely. Is metal popular in Finland? Yes, it is.
I'd say so, yeah.
Metal music came to the surface, so to say, like, not too long time ago. Well, yeah. It has always been here, but like nowadays, it's like, it's metal music is pop music in Finland.
Yeah, I guess Finland is,
it's like heavy metal country number one. In the end, of course, we only have like 5.4 million people in here. But still, if you compare to the amount of the people in the country, it's insane. All the time there are like some metal, all kinds of metal albums on the charts. And everybody, many, many people are dressing up to metal shirts and really like the music. I guess, I don't know, I guess you need a very energetic, aggressive kick that gives you more energy, at least to the people here in the north, in the dark.
Yeah. People ask if we are self-taught or went to some school to learn music.
I've been teaching myself for all the years. I've never been in any colleges or any schools. Self-taught.
I started by learning stuff myself. And then went to one teacher, didn't seem to work out because he was too jazzy for me back then. But then after a while found a really great teacher in Tampere, a guy called Tom Gardiner. Everybody should check out, great playing on Hateform albums, for example. Yeah, so really good teacher and got me into hard practicing and really concentrating on techniques and also getting into more about the practical theory. And then after moving to Helsinki, went to another great teacher here called Mikko Kosonen, who went to study in the States in the Berklee School of Music. And besides that, I've taken some basic theory lessons, but a lot of self-learning there as well. Books and tons of instructional videos and stuff.
Yeah. Where was that?
Tampere. That's where I'm from.
Tampere.
Yeah.
No, you guys don't have seven string guitars.
Yeah, we never really got into seven-string guitars because it feels so different. And also, I guess it would be okay if you just take the time and, you know, kind of get used to how it looks and feels in your hands. But we have this Land of Snow and Sorrow is now played in drop B flat tuning, which is just a half step higher than normal seven strings, lower string. So we're almost at the seven string register anyway, just with six strings tuned really low. But we have this, we have a couple guitars that Ibanez gave us that are the RGD models. These kind of guitars with this one also has 26 inch scale length, meaning the length of the string, so it kind of stays better in tune and intonation is better to get exact with the lower tuning, and also you don't need string tension is higher with lighter strings, makes it easier to play.
Yeah. What about Bathory? Bathory was a very, very good band, and the music still lives. I actually listened the album Blood on Ice, yeah, like after 5 years or so, or 10 years probably, and it sounded very good, super good songs. What does that question mean?
How old do you play? Does it mean
Jukka,
how
how old
long
do you
have
play?
we played or how?
How long? Well, how long have I played? I've played since the third grade in ground school, and now that I'm a guy of being of the 30s, so.
Yeah.
And when it comes to how old I'm gonna be, I'm still gonna have bass. I'm gonna have bass forever on my lap.
Yeah, same with me. I played for 12 years now,
Yeah.
and hopefully still many decades to come.
What is it?
What string gauge do you use?
Yeah,
I just got some new cages.
Yeah, I have a custom set 45, 65, 85, 105, and then 130, but on the other set, the lowest string is 145. Because I have two basses with two different tunings. The other bass is on the D tune, and the other one is on D tune, except the lowest string is tuned to C, which is kind of interesting tuning in a way, but I need that tuning for the few new songs, Songs of Winter and Stars and Time, because they I like it like that. Let's say like that.
Yeah, we have to kind of compromise a little bit, because we can't bring like four guitars each plus backups. Mm.
Yeah.
So yeah, we play the old songs that were recorded in E tuning. Those we play now in D tuning. Whole step lower. Then the drop B flat tuning we are doing with XFX pitch shifter. So we don't have a separate guitar just for Land of Snow and Zero. Somebody wanted me to show the Blue Ibanez. Unfortunately, it's not here.
I have
another Blue Ibanez, but the main Blue Ibanez, the Los Angeles Custom Shop one, is at the rehearsal place at the moment. Brand strings. Oh, my gauges are 11 to 56 set by Dad Dario at the moment. And I don't remember the individual gauges, but 11 in D high string, and then I use 56 for both D and C thickest string.
Yeah. Do you guys play any other instrument besides guitar, bass? I have to say honestly that I don't.
I've never seen you play guitar. Maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe why not? Yeah. That would be probably that fun, at least for you.
We should practice, maybe. Yeah, beyond the dark sun with everybody chasing instruments.
Yeah, that would be cool. Especially me on the drums.
Yeah, and Kai could sing.
Kai could sing, definitely. Yeah, but I've never actually played actively any other instruments. I've just focused on the bass guitars.
I used to play some drums. We had drums at family's garage as well as keyboards. So for some time I used to try to get some sounds out of them. But never really kind of concentrated so much.
Yeah. On those.
Also, I record some bass lines sometimes, some demos. Mm. But I wouldn't say that I'm an appropriate bass player in any way.
Was there some other questions on the Facebook side?
See, there's a bunch of. How about your bass influences?
My bass influences? Whoa. Lately, I have to say that I really haven't had any. My earliest influences probably. Well, that's a hard one, because when it comes to me, actually, I'm sort of a different guy. I like to listen to all kinds of music, and then I've even like many years ago, I listened to all kinds of stuff and just started playing bass on top of them somehow, rather than maybe checking one teacher or something like that. But I remember I used to dig a lot of Primus when it comes to Les Claypool. Mm. And I guess I have to say that when it comes to Claypool, not just playing Primus, but also other things that he does, is something that I really look followed and and when it comes to metal music, really haven't never had that many influences from their like metal music bass players. Maybe Steve DiGiorgio, who used to play in Testament and Death and stuff like that. He's a very good bass player, but it's like the stuff that, like, listening to metal, that at least in the old days, it was like more or less like huge guitar walls and the bass was there in the background. So not that I didn't get that much out of the, at least when it comes to metal music, bass playing. I think I brought my influences from other genres. But yeah, someone is asking Cliff Burton. I listened a lot of Metallica in the ground school, but I never wasn't that big fan of Mr. Burton, although he was a good bass player, definitely. But yeah, I have to say that it's probably Les Claypool, and that's it. Do you like American metal like Pantera? Yes, one of my all-time favorite albums is Far Beyond Driven and other Pantera stuff. And when it comes to the newer things like Lamb of God, they have nice songs. But I guess the one of the best American metal bands is Pantera, definitely.
Yeah, I think so too. I first got into them after hearing Cowboys from Hell, so
yeah,
that's always been kind of my favorite.
Yeah. Hey, someone is asking Victor Wooden.
Yeah.
He is an insane guy. Insane bass player.
Great stuff.
That's, I actually have a tab book at home, but I probably never ever opened it even. Because if I would start to try that stuff, of course, actually one day I'm sure I will open it and check out a few songs of his, but when it comes to his bass playing, it's so far beyond. It's like when that guy is playing bass, it sounds like he has a band around him.
Yeah.
Amazing, amazing guy with very, very unique technique. Like he uses a lot of slap, but one of his signature techniques is like using thumb up, down and up, and then playing with these three fingers. So he has like five picks, like doing this and all the tapping techniques. Amazing, amazing stuff. Do you know some Brazilian metal bands? Sepultura? Besides that, really haven't checked the scene that actively lately, so not really. If you can write us some Brazilian good metal bands, I will definitely check them out.
Here's an interesting one.
Do you slap? I slap.
Your bass.
My bass? That as well. And yeah, I used to do a lot of slap stuff and still a bit, not that much anymore, but maybe I'm just being lazy on that part because being concentrating on the other style of playing when it comes to Northern Winter Sun, stuff like that.
Here's a good question.
Yeah?
Are there any important things that Jari has transmitted to you that have changed your views in music? If so, which ones?
That's a good question.
That's a good question. I guess getting into this Asian kind of vibe through the movies and soundtracks.
Yeah.
That's one thing at least. Could have gotten into it some other way too, but I think at least I got it through Jari.
Yeah, well, definitely, because Jari put this Asian influence on the music, really brought something new on the table. Mm. Of course, heard that kind of stuff on the movie soundtracks and movies. We like to swap that all kinds of movies with Jari. But in like composing to your own music, that's very, very cool. And what was the question again?
Important things. But I guess kind of the kind of dedication that he puts in everything that he does is kind of really amazing to experience, and kind of probably that has kind of thought at least myself a lot how to kind of, I guess, what music can mean to one, and
yeah, probably it's the dedication as well when it comes to me, and yeah, and when it comes to Jari's composing styles, it's also given a lot of new views how to make music. And I've learned a lot actually when it comes to him composing all these orchestras. I'm starting to understand what is it called, like when melodies go across one another and
layered harmony.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you like Tosin Abasi?
Who's it?
The Animals as Leaders.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Crazy stuff.
Yeah, very crazy stuff. I heard only one of the
albums. I was really disappointed that I missed the Matuska. I mean, they couldn't come, something with the flights.
Hmm.
So, but yeah, cool stuff, definitely.
How is your relationship with your parents? I'm very close to my parents.
Yeah, me too.
Everybody should be very close to their parents, definitely. Family does matter a lot. What's your... What?
At least. Remember?
No. A little something. What is that? What was that?
Yeah, this first music video.
Oh yeah, a little something. What the hell was that? Yeah, that's what I was thinking as well when he released that. He brought up some new stuff on the table indeed. Like an extempore idea of Jari making a music video. On iPhone?
I guess so, yeah. iMac.
Oh, iMac, okay.
Then where do you teach? Currently in Helsinki, quite near the city center, at the Sonic Pump Studios.
Parenting with Jukka.
What?
What is the, what's your opinion on people comparing Time 1 to Nightwish? Well, that's something I haven't heard before. Okay, I understand the point that when it might come to the orchestras, but I really don't see any similarities.
Hmm.
Maybe because there ain't too many bands who use big orchestras, orchestration, so I might understand the comparison, but I don't think there's any similarity.
Yeah, I mean, there's some of the same orchestral instruments, but we have some more oriental stuff that Nightwish doesn't have, and they have some like some instruments that we don't use. But I think we have really different kind of melodies, and otherwise different kind of production, and different kind of playing. I would say, of course, the vocals are very different.
Mm.
I mean, guitars are very different, drums are different, the vocals are different, orchestras are a little bit the same kind of.
Well, similar kind of similar instruments.
Yeah.
Like in every classical or classical orchestra. Do your parents like the music you play? Yes. They really support us.
Mm-hmm.
My parents have always supported me when it comes to the playing. Is this tour going to be your first tour in the United States and the US? If so, what are you looking forward about coming here? Yes, this is our first North American tour. Very, very looking forward to come. Don't know what to expect. I mean that looking very positively.
Uh-huh.
I'm there and so excited to play the new music.
Mm-hmm.
And also play the old songs as well, because we haven't performed there yet. So very, very excited. Very, very excited indeed. Teemu and Jukka, do you consider music a job? If you don't, do you have a job? I have to say that I consider music as my passion, which also includes the word job, which I love to do. Not a regular day job, so to say, that you might get bored into that. Of course, regular day job can be super nice if you like it.
Mm.
And that's what I love when it comes to music. It's everything. It's a hobby, it's a passion, it's work, job, holidays as well.
Mm. Yeah, it's a lifestyle.
Mm.
It's a definitely passion as well for me.
Mm.
And I'm really glad to be able to also work as a professional musician.
Yeah.
It's a dream come true already.
When it comes to, are you planning to do some touring in Latin America? Well, we already answer to that, but of course, for you guys who were in the chat before, hopefully we're gonna have the chance to do that next year. We're gonna invade some new territories.
Mm.
So definitely hope that we're gonna do that.
Somebody asks if I would recommend Locked Trem. It depends on what you play. I mean, I like playing with the whammy bar for certain stuff, but in winters and stuff, there's not really any whammy bar stuff, so I've plucked my bridges in the current live guitars, because it's then easier to tune it, stays better in tune, more stable, and also it affects a little bit sound when if you put like wood blocks around the tremolo block. Maybe gets you a little bit more sustain. So I like it, but I also like playing with the running bar. So that's also one reason why I have different guitars.
Do you guys listen any other music genres besides metal?
Definitely.
Yes, definitely. Should I say, Busta Rhymes, Massive Attack, Dredge, Mew, several kinds of pop music and
yeah, pop and you know even jazzy stuff, and as I mentioned earlier, like fusion stuff. I like to even instrumental.
Kind of
stuff and yeah, all kinds of good music.
Good there. Music, yeah. Do you guys like Desperados beer? Yeah, I drank a few. I was on a holiday in San Francisco for a while. It was nice. I don't know where Desperados comes from, but like that.
I never tried.
Finnish winters.
Oh, sorry.
Did you find something else?
There was about the whammy bar question. Misunderstood it about if I would recommend some Ibanez without a whammy. Yeah, there's. Personally, I don't like the ones without the whammy bar. I mean the whammy bridge, because it feels different when you're palm muting to your hand. It feels different, so I like to block my tremolo rather. But actually, Ibanez came with this new model just lately that has a fixed bridge that looks basically the same as a floating tremolo. Can't remember which model this was, but I just saw it in at the local distributor, so you can probably check it out at Ibanez.com. Some RG model it was, Prestige. Sorry, I...
No, that was fine. That good that you corrected that. Yeah, someone's asking about Finnish winters. Very cold.
Sometimes.
Very dark also, but from January on, or even earlier in the daytimes, the sun is shining.
Yeah, that's nice.
And February, March, absolutely beautiful, white snow everywhere, sun is shining. It's cold, but I don't mind.
No,
very beautiful.
I like winter, but
yeah. What?
But sometimes it gets too cold.
Yeah. Well, when it's minus 40 degrees, I don't know how many people get the kicks out of that anymore.
RGR. I think it's RGR Prestige. Maybe I Google it so you can see what I meant. It's not RGR. I've got a couple RGRs myself. Let's see. Check the Facebook stuff. Well,
okay, yeah, sure. Oh, yeah, there's one guy asking about the that Jari said that me and Valtias Mustatuuli from Artemisia sing some deep growls for the album. Well, Mr. Mustatuuli just did some brief part in Songs of Winter and Stars.
Mm. And also changed his name to Alpha Valtias.
Alpha Valtias, yeah. yeah, he only sang like
a few things here and there.
Few words here and there.
Yeah.
You know. And yeah, well, I earlier said I made some low growls on Songs of Winter and Stars and on Time.
The guitar I meant was Archie 3521. That's the one I tried and felt really good. So you should go to your local shop and check it out if you like the feeling of the tremolo bridge under your hand, but still prefer a fixed bridge.
What type of person is Jari in his personal life? Easygoing, great guy, and absolutely a great friend.
Mm.
Do you guys hang out when you're not in the studio or on tour? Yes. We see each other as well otherwise. Do you ever meet up in his house just to jam? Whoa, I've never done that though.
I've done Have you? A couple times, yeah. Sometimes when I go to check out some stuff, then we just pick up guitars and jam on the side of the bed.
Ah, cool. But on the side of the bed.
Yeah. Mm. Well, you know how it is. It's the computer, it's the bed.
Yeah.
Favorite food?
Favorite food? A lot of all kinds of food.
Yeah, I like a lot of stuff too. Nothing really fancy. Like, I like homemade, you know, potatoes and meatballs, Finnish style. And chicken fillet and rice. And
one speciality that I like wherever I go is sushi.
That's for me.
Hey, Teemu, are you going to play any solos on the upcoming album, or will you just play amazing lead guitar?
Yeah, I'll just play amazing lead guitar. There's some solo kind of stuff on sometime that I'll be playing live. But anyway, most of the solos, if people are surprised that there's not so many solos on the first part, there's gonna be more solos on the second part for sure.
Hmm.
It wasn't planned, but that's just the way we split the album from the middle. Most of the solos got to the last part.
Yeah, it's second.
Just ran out of the air conditioning here.
Yeah, it's kind of quiet in here now. Hey, where was it? Is Jari God? Are the synth stuff truly so difficult it would be impossible to play them live, as Jari said to Inferno magazine? What's your opinion?
Well, we kind of answered this already.
Yeah, well, we can say it again. There are probably some new guys online, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're very, very challenging and
Yeah.
Some parts are very impossible to play.
Yeah, probably some are impossible because Jari didn't make the orchestrations with the keyboard or anything. He just made with the
programmed them.
Yeah, programmed them with the computer. So they are not. He didn't think that can somebody play this. He thought that does this sound good.
Yeah.
So probably somebody could figure out how to play them.
Mm. Blood cake. What is a blood cake? Verilettu?
I guess not my favorite.
Do you guys like At the Gates? Slaughter of the Soul is a great album, definitely. Favorite South Park character? Timmy! Or is it Jimmy? Both of them.
If you were not musicians, what would you be? I guess I would be either some sort of sportsman or some Lego engineer.
Lego engineer. Yeah. What the hell is that?
I was really into Legos when I was a child.
Oh, Lego engineer. Yeah. I probably would have started concentrating totally on being as an ice hockey goalie. I probably would be something like that.
Yeah, it's funny, I was ice hockey goalie too.
You were?
Yeah, we had.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, didn't remember. Do you like Opeth? Yes. Opeth is a very, very nice atmospheric band. I've been listening to that band ever since from... What is the album?
Blackwater Park?
No, an earlier one. My Arms, Your Hers. Yeah. Jimmy!
Judas Priest or Iron Maiden? I have to say Iron Maiden.
Yeah, Iron Maiden. Yes, yes. Do you like ketchup and sugar? What is that sort of a question? Yes.
Together, yeah.
Together, yep.
Creative Guitar 1 and 2 and Rock Discipline. Yes, good books. Creative Guitar by Guthrie Govan. Rock Discipline by Petrucci.
Do you like the video game Skyrim? Oh yeah, someone asked about video games. I like them. Sometimes I play quite a lot, sometimes there are longer breaks. Skyrim is one of them, which is very cool. And NHL hockey and Fallout 3. What else? Yeah, NHL is actually one that I've played all the way from 1995.
I remember NHL 95. That's the last game probably that I was really into on PC.
Yeah.
But after that, I haven't played that much video games of any kind.
Yeah. Was there some questions about the album?
About the album?
About the album, yeah. About our new forthcoming album. Oh yeah, guys. One thing that I'm gonna do now that the people who don't know yet, I'm going to send you a few links. How can I do it? I'm going to show you, send you a few links.
You can copy or you can write it.
Yeah, I'm just going to write it.
I can answer a couple of questions while you guys are writing.
Did I write correctly?
Somebody asks, says, your music sounds a lot like there's some unhappiness, a yearning for a different world and torment because of what is happening around us. Is that the feeling for Jari and the band and the reason for specific melodies and lyrics? Well, I think there's the melancholy feelings are kind of creating a lot of great music and feeling having difficult times and feeling that making music can be really kind of healing and it's a good way to put your even bad energy into and kind of make something good out of bad things.
Yeah, exactly. And one thing that when it comes to life in general is like making music, you can channel your negative energy through music or listening to it.
No.
Which is really like a therapy or like a healing effect. I really, really personally, of course, I leave music. I love to listen all kinds of music as well, and it's a very like a healing factor. Rather listening to music and have good vibes than some idiots around the world who go beating up other people to put their own issues and negative energies on others.
Have you ever seen Dio live? I've seen Dio maybe 4 times. I really regret the fact that I never got to meet Dio. I was really hoping that we would have played some festival together once and could have said hi to him. A huge idol of mine.
What? Silver Leaves Berkeley said, haha, time went out of stock. I don't think so either. Yeah, the few links that I send you guys is was that where you can actually where you can order the album if you like. There was a American link and a European link, and
they are already somewhere.
Yeah, they already.
Maybe we copy them.
Yeah, we should.
People can actually see them.
They were there. Just up a bit. There's the first one. Then there's the other one as well, a bit higher there. And a bit lower.
So that's the
there.
USA link for ordering the album. If you want to support us, you can go there. And this is the for Europe.
Yeah.
What about Wacken? Yep, this we answered already as well, that if we are invited, we'll be happy to come.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
What do you usually do in a day off? We haven't had a day off in a long time on tour.
No. And we really won't have any day offs.
Yeah.
No, no, at least on the recent tours.
Yeah.
Well, if you would have one, what would we do?
Probably just relax in the hotel room or maybe.
Go out and check some.
Yeah.
Check some sites if there's gonna be something around. What was the very first CD you ever bought? Oh, I can't remember. Was it Amorphis, Carillion Isthmus, or Sentenced? Sentenced, I mean, North from Here.
For me, it was Black Sabbath Collection album.
Okay.
Right before Iron Maiden.
Yeah. Do you have any animals in your house other than Kai? Because he's a beast. Yeah, Kai is our only animal at the moment. Kai needs 3 herders. 3 herders to that we can keep the beast chained. Are you worried about the reaction time is going to get? No, at least I don't not worry about all.
Yeah, because we feel that we've done our very best. So yeah. It's up to people. If they like it, we're very glad about it. And if they don't like it, then they are free to not like it.
Yeah, exactly. And we stand behind our music and even if anyone else wouldn't enjoy, we would love it still. We will see what happens, and there will be reviews coming coming now, so hopefully we're gonna start getting some feedback.
Mm.
But definitely would like to hear some real feedback on the road as well, and not just only from the journalists, so to say.
Check everything from here.
Yeah. Oh, we're not checking out the new messages. There's 55 new messages. Oh. Oops, sorry guys. What is your opinion on Vark Vikernes? Vark did good music, but you don't have to be an insane person to start killing others. Do you like some band with female vocals? Yes.
Sure.
Examples. Evanescence. Damn.
I like Nightwish. Some of their stuff.
Yeah. I personally like Nightwish now even more than Florianse is on the vocals. I think her voice is great, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Teemu, what is your favorite guitar solo of all time?
Favorite guitar solo of all time? That's hard.
One of Jari's solos?
No, that would be probably something from Yngwie Malmsteen's Live in Leningrad.
The Gathering? Yep. Annek is an absolutely amazing singer. Oh, but she's not in the band anymore. Arch Enemy? Yeah, kicks ass. In another way.
Do we have any rituals just before going on stage? Well, everybody has their own warm-up rituals. Vocal exercises and finger warm-ups and... kind of just getting into the mood, and then usually we have a group hug and kind of more chant before going
on
stage, just before.
Yeah. Maybe we should start having like a 2-hour war mantra or something. Collaboration with Temin Townsend, maybe. Well, that would kick ass. Would be fun. Do you guys like composing in your free time, any solo project? Well, I haven't been composing that much, but of course I've been writing songs to Norther and stuff, other bands as well, so I haven't done that in a while, but almost every day I come up with some idea, which I write down on my phone. Yeah. And maybe one day I will start looking at them more precisely.
Yeah, same with me. I've got a lot of small ideas and clips and riffs and melodies recorded that are maybe gonna be put together at some point.
Yeah. Any plans to tour in the UK? Yeah, hopefully we can sort out or plan like a proper UK tour.
Oh, that'd be great.
That would consist of several shows in UK.
Cool. Are you excited to tour with Elevady? Yes, definitely.
Definitely. Do you like Lord of the Rings? Will you watch the Hobbit movie? Yes, definitely gonna watch the Hobbit movie.
Yeah, you had it on your iPad.
Some preview, some app.
Yeah.
It looked very nice. And definitely wanna see it. Actually, it's gonna come in the movies. When the US tour is gonna start.
Yeah, you should try to go, like I said, see it in IMAX.
Yeah. Yeah. Jukka and Teemu, do you meet members from other Finnish bands sometimes?
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes, yeah. Well, let's say that the scene or, yeah, Finnish scene is
very small, and everybody kind of knows each other.
Yeah.
One way or another.
Yeah.
So, who did we see at Nosturi? Like Amorphis guys and. Bunch of people.
You guys listen to Devin Townsend? Yeah, everybody probably in Winterson listens to Devin's stuff. Very, very unique. Cool stuff that Devin has made. There's actually quite many guys asking, will you do a reunion with Nother?
You should.
With Petri. Well, who knows? Let's see. Hey, finally, Teemu and Jukka for president.
Oh, yeah.
Why? I wonder how the Finns would like to see a two-headed monster on the throne.
What's your favorite sport and favorite team?
Where?
Favorite sport and favorite team? I'd say probably I'm still most into ice hockey, though I don't follow it regularly, but enjoy watching at least the Olympics and all the big games, championships.
Yeah.
So there, of course, Finland is my favorite, but for local teams, I don't have such a favorite. When I used to play more ice hockey, I was a fan of Tappara from Tampere.
Yeah, my favorite sport, it is ice hockey, although the other one is floorball. Floorball is like, you guys who don't know the sport, it's like ice hockey without any equipment, clothes on though, and without any skates and no ice. It's like ice hockey in a light, gearless way. Only your indoor shoes and the stick that you play with a plastic ball. I do play it myself, and I would love to do ice hockey as well, but there's kind of limited time. But I have to say that I'm watching NHL here and there, and when it comes to there are very, very nice, a lot of good hockey teams.
Yeah.
But I don't have a favorite team, but one team that I like to play NHL hockey on PlayStation 3 is Minnesota Wild. I don't know why, but I just like it.
I don't follow NHL so much, but sometimes when there's news about Teemu Selänne, I'm making new, breaking new records with the Ducks. That's nice to read and check out some YouTube clips.
So street hockey, no floorball. Street hockey would be cool as well. Would be nice to try.
I've tried one day. Played, I think. Well, I mean, we always played when it was summer in the ring with the shoes and the sticks.
Yeah, like that stuff. Like yard, it's like yard hockey, but I think street hockey. I was thinking if it's a professional street hockey. Rugby, whoa, insane! But I would like to try American football. I would really, really would like to try it. But probably I would be the guy who's being on the, what is it, a wall dude underneath the pile or something. Would you like to tour Japan? Also, what is the best place you've ever toured? Definitely we would like to go to Japan, and I hope it will happen next year.
Yeah.
What's the best place we've ever toured? Well, basically, we only have Finnish shows and a few European tours. We haven't gone further.
It's hard to say. Yeah. Germany is always great. Bloodstock was totally amazing.
Yeah.
Everywhere there's amazing fans, so it's hard to say what is the best place.
Yeah.
Of course, it's nice to play in our hometown as well.
Yeah.
Kajira, yeah.
Oh, I also wanted to thank you guys. I got the highest grade on my music exam for playing Star Child. Thank you. Whoa, good luck, man.
Yeah, great.
If our songs bring good grades, keep on going on that. Do we play Guitar Hero? I tried this a few times. It's goddamn hard.
I never tried.
It's very hard, actually. Although there are only a few buttons, but it differs so much from the real playing. Because you try to play the Guitar Hero guitar like a real guitar, and then it really doesn't work like that. Our relations to NC Ferrum is very good. Yes. Great guys. Great guys. Teemu, do you still sleep with a teddy bear?
Rarely, but sometimes.
Oh.
Do you?
Not anymore.
The same.
I have a teddy bear that is old as me, but it's my parents' place. Now I probably lost all the heavy metal points by saying this.
Somebody was asking about latest Metalore album. Haven't heard.
Me neither. Nope.
I like some of the old Metalore stuff though. For a certain mood. Somebody keeps asking about the Kalma guys and Antti Kokko. They're from the north, so we don't really know.
No, I never met these guys. Does Jari do silly things when he sleeps?
That's hard to say.
Don't remember.
No, I don't think he snores or anything.
No. Probably not. We'll inform you guys if he's gonna do something silly.
What time is it in Finland now? It's 12:08. 12:08.
Yeah.
So, I guess we should wrap it up soon.
Yeah. It's kinda late over here. Really, really, of course, it would be nice to talk with you guys, like, for several hours. Continue. There are great questions coming in, nice comments the whole time. And kinky comments as well, which is cool. In a few months I'm going to make a Winter Sun tattoo. Already got the design. Made it myself. Cool. I actually been thinking about it as well. I was thinking about it a long time to get another tattoo. I'll probably, maybe one day I'll take both. We'll see.
What do you guys like to drink? I like to drink water and milk. Low-fat milk is the best drink to go with food. Cold.
Water is the best drink above all. But of course, then comes cider and other stuff as well. Android or Apple?
No. We have about quite many Apple machines in the room.
Yeah. You could do it. Do what? Something.
Funniest moment with you guys in Wintersun. All the tours are always, there's some funny stuff going on.
Yeah. We like we talk a lot of easygoing stuff and joke around.
Yeah, Kai is kind of the.
Yeah, he's
the one usually who keeps us laughing the whole time.
Yeah. Oh, Yari, last weekend.
Yeah.
When he fucked up Winter Madness beginning. Shame on Yari. Well, I'm just saying this not to provoke him, because I made a mistake in last year's Bloodstock with the same song. I started too early, and now Yari started it too early in the weekend. So I have to say here officially.
Cow milk or what kind of milk?
Soya milk is very good, but mm-hmm. Yeah, you probably prefer the cow.
Cow milk, the Finnish version. I'm not sure what version there is, like in the US. Even the German milk is a little bit different. Hard to get the Finnish kind of milk in other countries, I guess. It's kind of very low fat, I guess.
Tell us a joke. Oh God, I'm bad at these. I just really didn't say. Well, I just heard a joke on the weekend. I'll try to translate in English if I can. Give me a second. Where?
Do you have bugs in your hair?
Bugs? In my hair or in our hair?
Do they look like that?
At least I don't feel any.
Will the instrumental version be on iTunes? For those who missed there was the 500 pieces limited edition True Nuclear Blast mail order and sold out already, unfortunately. It won't be on iTunes, at least for now. But let's see if we're gonna make something like the special package then later on.
Yeah.
With some more instrumental versions or something.
Yeah. Oh yeah. What was the joke? What is Yari Mäenpää doing in a kiosk? He's charging time credit on his travel card. Yeah, that was the thing. Some fan or some came to me in the Helsinki show and said this to me. I was laughing my ass off.
There's something about SpongeBob. You're a fan of SpongeBob.
Yeah, SpongeBob kicks ass. I have one t-shirt of SpongeBob.
Austrian milk is the best. I have to try it.
Austrian milk? Or Australian?
Austrian.
Austrian milk. Aha.
Kittens or puppies? Kittens. I like puppies too.
Both. Both. On the topic of hair, what shampoo do you use? What shampoo do you use actually then?
I think I have we should first get endorsement.
I'm using Tiki.
I think I have Pantene.
Pantene. Will the time to artwork to connect to Taiwan? Yes, they will, because both of the albums are the same concept. So yes, and they will be connected to one another. Of course, they will surely look different, but they will match.
Yeah, there's gonna be some connection, definitely.
Yeah.
Somebody asks about your licks and tricks. Do you have a part in the licks and tricks?
Yeah. Three parts.
Everybody has their own licks and tricks, and Jukka's preview is also in YouTube already.
Yeah.
You can see, and then about the Perk Knuckle pickups, I've got Black Hawks and Aftermaths.
Mm. So you use the same guy with the artwork? We will see that. We have some concepts, and we really, really love the
Cameron
Gray's art, so it would be a good continuation to use him in as well. But we will see.
This stream is very funny. I think so
too. Hmm?
Somebody thinks this stream is very funny.
Okay.
Any advice for people who want to be musicians? If you really want to do it, then go for it. You know. Or anybody else who wants to do anything with their life, I'd say that, you know, you can do it. It's just up to you.
Yeah.
Anything is possible. But if you want to be a musician, you should be ready to work hard and have dedication. Be patient. Things happen. Just do what you want. Have your own thing.
Yeah. Some practical hints for starting musicians or players, maybe listening to music.
Mm.
One thing that actually I did in the beginning is that I played my favorite songs, and I mean I listened to them, but then I started playing on top of them.
Yeah, I
started to find the right notes, and then finding that, and then trying to get it more deeply to the real rhythm, and through that, after like trying to starting evolving and then starting to find the technique, how to really play it, and and I think it's like a fun way to start.
It's of course a whole different story nowadays when there's YouTube. You can find lesson for everything in a second if you want. It wasn't like that when we started out, but I think in general I would say I would recommend to keep an open mind in all styles of music and all kinds of players, and you know, trying to learn from everybody and not be narrow-minded. About YouTube and internet stuff, I think it's good sometimes not to go where the where it's easiest way, you know. Like it's easy to, you know, watch the lesson and you know see how it's done and then do it yourself. But I would also that's also what I tell to my own students, that it's really important to use your own ears. And like you said, that he started to just jam along his favorite albums, that kind of learning how to pick up things on your ear rather than watch it on a tap and then just put your fingers where the tap says to put it.
Rather
try to make the connection when you hear a note, that you can kind of you find it yourself on the fretboard or whatever instrument you're playing. I think that's really important. And also, if you're aiming to be a professional musician, it's a must, definitely. That helps when learning songs and memorizing stuff. Nobody's going to be there writing taps for you.
Yeah, exactly. And maybe also like try to learn what is it like, improvising skills, so to say, that if you, for example, check out some sort of teacher who teaches you how to do a leak, of course, you know now how to do the leak when you look at this lesson, but how do you use that in practice, really, like on your own, so to say, and modulate that to something else and start really using these techniques properly, not just knowing this or that thing that I checked from these teachers or something like that. Starting to try to stand on your own ground and trust your own ways playing.
Skype lessons are asked again. I already replied that probably beginning of next year I've organized stuff so I can start having some Skype lessons.
When it comes to me, well, why not? I might also be able to make a few Skype lessons as well. Let's see, we have to organize our schedules and everything and see how much there is time to do.
Any plans on live DVD? Some, but nothing concrete for now.
But yeah, I'm sure we will one day would
be able
to release proper live stuff.
Yeah, but we're gonna be carrying some cameras with us for the tours and posting some stuff on YouTube and Facebook. So
yeah, definitely. It's gonna be
clips anyway for you to see.
Yeah.
Make Facebook demo. No. I've been planning to make one for a long time, but I've always skipped it because I thought it's better to stay out, that it doesn't take too much time to hang out there. But yeah, I think I'm gonna do it now when we go on tour. It's easier to stay in touch with some people. And also, get in touch with the fans.
Yeah.
Any plans for music videos in the future? Yes, we were almost making a music video for some time, but for schedule reasons and also budget reasons, we decided to save that budget for other stuff, and when we do a video, then we want to really make it special and not something made in with the hasty schedule.
Yeah, exactly.
Do you like mosh pit? Yeah, it's, I mean, when you're in the audience yourself and you don't want to be in the mosh pit, then it's not nice. So I hope that everybody who is in the mosh pit also kind of considers the other people around there who have paid their tickets and come to see the show and maybe want to, you know, not get hit or have a booth in their mouth. And sometimes it's so crowded that you just get into mosh pit or near mosh pit when you don't want to. So I think people should be considerate about other people, but for those who want to be in the mosh pit, it's great to see that kind of action during the gig. I
mean, yeah, definitely. It's absolutely great to see that the guys are having good time.
Yeah.
Definitely a great goddamn time. Definitely. Yeah. Do you want to sleep right now? Well, it's past midnight, but we're used to this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Best concert you ever been to? I think production-wise, I'd say the Dream Theater concert there. Most recent tour was really amazing. Musically only, maybe. It's hard to say.
Yeah, hard to say indeed. Visually, atmospheric-wise, I have to say probably Massive Attack in Provinssirock in Finland back in 2005, 2004, something like that. Nine Inch Nails also at the same festival. They played a set which wasn't that industrious, more like a rock band version, although it was the band.
Okay.
But they didn't use that much of that industrial stuff. Which was kind of funny to hear, like, heavy metal versions of Nine Inch Nails songs. More heavy versions. Very cool.
Yeah. Well, also, Iron Maiden, after the Brave New World tour in Helsinki was probably my favorite shows ever. Is Jari asleep? Probably, or going soon. Do you like Do you like King Diamond? I do. I'm looking forward to Tuska.
Oh yeah, he's gonna be in Tuska. Cool. Yeah. It'd be nice to see. Nice to see. Can you cook and thoughts on Dave Mustaine? No, that's a nice combo question. Combo. Yes, I can cook. I've heard lately that I've been a bit lazy to cook, but yes, I can. And thoughts on Dave Mustaine? Megadeth has great music, but I don't know what has got into Dave that he has quite crazy comments nowadays. Well, everybody has their opinions.
Yeah, I don't agree with some of his personal opinions, but I like still Megadeth music. And about cooking, yes, I guess I could say I can cook, but nothing. Just some practical stuff.
Jukka, have you ever played a full song on a 4-string bass? Interesting question, but that's actually a goddamn good question, because I have to say that I've never ever played a full song with a 4-string bass. Never.
Did you ever have a 4-string?
Never. Even the first bass that I got, maybe I had a 4-stringer for a while. So, damn, yes, I have actually. Secondary high school, I might have played a few full songs on a 4-string bass, but soon after that I bought a 5-stringer and always had 5-string basses. And also I had a 6-stringer back in the days, but I preferred the 5-er a lot more.
Tuska 2013, you really hope so?
Yep. Metal Days 2013, yeah. hope for that as well. Ever heard Pathfinder and Gallinarius? Nope. Really, I know Pathfinder the movie, but
yeah, maybe. What took us so long to get to North America? Well, so long. We probably didn't get offers from there.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not us who decide where we go, it's the management and
Basically management, but also the promoters,
yeah,
who want
yeah
Wintersun to play somewhere.
Yeah, definitely. That's so. If people want to see us somewhere, the best way to get us somewhere is to get the album, buy it in your country, so the promoters see that this band actually exists, and also you can, you know, write mail or contact anyway your local promoter and tell about this band that you like.
Yeah,
that's the best way to get us in Greece or in wherever. We'd be totally thrilled to play anywhere we can. More memorable the Corona story.
Both. Hard to say. Do you guys take drugs and get weird? No, we don't do drugs. Nope. Music is our drug. Nothing else. And that's it.
Worst thing ever happened when you were on stage? Nothing. Worst thing ever happened. Nothing really horrible. I mean, some minor technical problems happen every now and then. That,
yeah.
Kind of buggers.
One show in... Where was
well,
it?
Well, we lost the electricity totally at one show.
Oh,
no,
yeah.
No band. But it wasn't that bad. I just played the drum solo and we continued.
Yeah. Yeah, but there was one show... I can't remember where he was in Europe. This one guy tried to tie my shoelaces together. Really? Like, God damn it.
It kind of makes it harder.
Yeah. Yuka, do you take Cliff Burton as influence? In a way, yes. Not my main influences, but I used to listen a lot and still do old Metallica, especially Master of Puppets.
Do you guys see the artwork I did? Do you guys see the shirt I made, Guy? Two Way Finger Band.
Doesn't sound familiar. At least, according to the nick.
Not sure what you mean.
Reasons for changing time cover. Well, we wanted to change it because we wanted to improve the cover, and also it leaked to the internet a long, long time ago.
Yeah, it was.
And we also wanted to have. How should I say, more in-depth cover in a way, and I think we got the cover in a way that there's this face of a man and then the world. It really shows like what is it? mental stuff, and all kinds of things that goes in the mind.
And you guys take fish oil.
Where?
Winterman says.
I don't see where.
Yeah, I do take fish oil.
I have to start taking it again.
favorite.
Jukka looks tired. Maybe. I don't know.
You have to get up in what? 4 hours? 5?
Yeah. Yeah, we have a rough schedule with the shows on the weekend and
all the other
work stuff and all everything that we do, all the preparations for many shows and all the practical stuff. So
yeah,
I might have some bit tiredness here and there.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff going behind the scenes. Even if you don't hear us in a couple of days in Facebook or something, there's constantly something band related going forward and new stuff happening.
Do Do we get much sleep while touring? Yes, we do. Of course, it depends on us.
But yeah.
We've
had really good conditions.
Yes.
On tours thus far.
And of course, we have kind of like a not that regular rhythm, daily rhythm. Because of playing shows in the evening and...
Yeah, of course, it's kind of... It's not the easy to be on tour because it's... you have to stay up long, and you can't just stay up, but you have to be the most alert and most fresh in the whole day when the show is up. And sometimes it's not easy, but it's also really rewarding. I think we're not the hardest partying band, so we might get more sleep than some other bands.
Of course. Yeah, but if we're not the hardest partying band, it doesn't mean that we have a good time.
Yeah,
definitely. We hang out a lot and have a very nice time.
Yeah.
I could listen to you guys all night long. Yeah, we could listen to ourselves as well. This is very, very fun to do this chat thing.
Thanks for everybody who...
Yeah, definitely.
...joined.
Spank you all. But I think it's still... On the other hand, it would be time to ending the chat. Although how nice it is at the moment. And we should do this the other day, another day again. And
maybe we can do one on tour with the whole band or something.
Yeah, we're gonna keep you posted through our Facebook page and of course our homepage. So that we will plan a few chat sessions more and continue the talks. There's so many questions coming. We were able to answer it only like a minor part of them, but shall we say good night or have a nice day in the stateside? And we're gonna keep you posted to Facebook and through our homepage, and of course our new album comes out next Friday and a few days later in the States.
Yeah, and the new website is gonna be online any moment, and the web shop is supposed to be working soon too.
Yeah.
So you can find the new merch there.
And also we're gonna update some personal stuff.
Yeah, there's gonna be
all the band members and everything, so there's more stuff to check out.
A lot of new stuff on the website. There's going to be also exclusive fan section that you just have to sign up for. And you're going to get some special stuff, special offers. And what are we going to have there? Special campaign stuff.
Yeah, campaign stuff and competitions and
competitions.
More special stuff going on that side. Definitely, yeah. But hey, we say good night and have a nice day, guys, and we're gonna see you at the shows and on the chats as well. So keep up posted.
Alrighty.
Alright.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Bye.